So today we're going to discuss about the Facebook and alloys. So Facebook, it is defined as any homogeneous, physically distinct and mechanically separable portion. So it is possible to see the differentiation, and also we are able to separate the system by mechanical wise. Then phase one is explaining the different phase. For example, gaseous phase. So the gaseous phase is completely miscible with each other. For example, air. So we are not able to differentiate any gas in the gas mixture. In liquid phase, we are having the liquid, and it is discussed in two categories. One is completely miscible, and another one is immiscible. So solid phase. So solid phase. Example, the calcium carbonate. So this calcium carbonate, when undergoing the decomposition, again it is producing solid calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. Okay, so it is an example for that phase only. So now we are going to discuss about the component. So it is the smallest number of independently variable constituent. For example, we are discussing about this PCl5, and another one example is water. So in water, we are having three states. For example, solid, ice, and liquid, and vapor. In the smallest number of the constant, independent variable constant is water. That is constant. Degree of freedom is what are the factors involving the change of the system. That is how it is defined as the minimum number of independent variable factors. For example, temperature. When the ice is melted to water melts, we need some temperature increase. Then pressure. So pressure is needed in many reactions, and the concentration. That is, the concentration is the biggest factor in all the chemical reactions. So these are considered as the important degree of freedoms. Okay. So the degree of freedom is having the four values. One is 0, 1, 2, 3. If the degree of freedom is 0, means it is called as non-variant or invariant. And 1 means it is called univariant, 2 means bivariant, 3 means it is called as trivariant. Then, so now we explaining the three factors with the help of this example. Ice, water, vapor. So here, the ice is the solid phase, water, liquid phase, the vapor, that is water vapor is the gaseous phase. So here we are having three phases, and the smallest variable component is water, and here the degree of freedom is here. It is not having any degree of freedom. Okay, so in this, the temperature, pressure, concentration is not playing any role. So here it is not having any degree of freedom. So now, if this component is one, means it is called as one component system. Okay, so the best example of one component system is water. So the water have three possible phases, that is already we saw the solid, liquid and vapor. So when the solid, that is ice, is melted to liquid, it is having an equilibrium between solid and the liquid. Similarly, when the water in liquid state is boiled and is converted to the vapor, it is having an equilibrium between liquid and vapor. That is how much liquid is converted into vapor, that is we are having the vapor, that is the meaning. So that is an equilibrium between liquid and vapor. Similarly, the sublimation, that is the solid is, or the vapor is converted into the solid state, so it is called the sublimation. So it is also happening. Okay. So this is the phase diagram. So for phase diagram for the one component system. So here we are having three curves. That is this curve, and that one, and this one. Okay. So this curve is obtained between the that is here, before going to the curve, we are having the areas. That is, this area is shown the solid phase, this liquid phase, and the gaseous phase. So this curve is obtained between the solid to liquid. That is, the solid is melted and it is converted into the liquid. So that is an equilibrium obtained between the solid and the liquid. Similarly, the liquid is converted into gas. So here, at this curve, at any point, there is an equilibrium obtained between the liquid and gas. Okay? And here, we are having a gas to solid, that is sublimation reaction. Okay? So here, another one curve, I mean here one the metastable equilibrium. That is, in metastable equilibrium, we are having a supercooled water. The supercooled water means that is, it is very chilled water, and a fraction of a second it is formed into ice. That is called it the supercooled water. And here, when the temperature is increased, okay, the curve's status also changed. Okay, here this curve is inclined towards upper. That is pressure. This curve inclination is indicating the pressure increase means automatically the temperature increase. That means pressure is related to temperature in indirect proportion. That means pressure increase means melting point is decreased by that. Okay. So here all these things are explained in the diagrams. That is curve OA is vaporization curve. That is, the liquid is converted into the gaseous state. So here the degree of freedom is calculated with the help of this phase rule. F is equal to C minus P plus 2. So here already we saw that it is a one component system. So C is equal to 1. Phase is 2. That is, here water, liquid, it is converted into vapor. So 2 phase. And this formula is applied. So we are having 1. So at the curve OA, degree of freedom is 1. Similarly, the curve OB, so it is sublimation curve. This is where vapor is converted into solid. That is, here it is called sublimation curve. So similar to them, that is, the phase rule is applied. Here also it is univariate. The next one, OC, that is, the OC is melting point curve. That is, the solid ice is converted into liquid. So in this state, the temperature is increased. So that is equilibrium obtained between the ice and the water. So here already I told about this one, that is slightly inclined towards the pressure. That is, when the pressure is increased, automatically the melting point of ice is decreased. Okay, that is explained. So here the degree of freedom is 1. So in all the curves, the degree of freedom is 1. Okay. The next one, the three curves are joined at a point. That point is called O, that is triple point. Three curves are attached at a point, it is called point O. So at the point O, we are having the three phases. What are they means? Solid, liquid, and also vapor. So that is an equilibrium happening between the solid, liquid, and the vapor. So in this point, when you are applying the phase rule, okay, we are getting degree of freedom is 0, that is it is non-variant, that is invariant. Okay. The next one, areas. So in the curves, we are having the areas between the curves. That is AOC, BOC, and AOB. In every area, we are having only one state, that is one phase. Maybe solid or liquid or ice. It is indicated by this one. So here, the degree of freedom is 2. The next one is two-component system or multi-component system. So in the two-component system, we are not applying the ordinary the degree of, phase rule. That is, in solid liquid equilibrium, we are not considering the gaseous phase. So the phase rule is reduced. Okay. So the reduced phase rule is indicated as F dash. That is, F dash is equal to C minus P plus 2 is turned into plus 2. Okay. So here, this rule is also called as condensed phase rule. Okay. So in this condensed phase rule, we are only considering the temperature and the concentration of the particular system. And also, another thing is why we are considering this reduced phase rule means if the phase diagram is a graphical representation. So we are able to draw the diagram only x-axis and y-axis, not in the y-axis. That is, it is not possible to draw the three-dimensional diagram. So we want the need of this reduced phase rule. Okay, so in this reduced phase rule, already I told about this thing. So here the gaseous phase is not considered. So effect of pressure is regulated. So we are using the reduced phase rule. Okay, yes, same thing. The physical C minus P plus 1 formula we are using. So based upon this, we are going to see another one example for this. So we are going to explain this thing for lead cellular eutectic system. Okay. So in this, the eutectic system, what is the meaning by eutectic means? At a point we beyond having too solid, and it smells or present in the liquid state. So at this critical time, the two solids are present and it is possible to separate, but it smells or miscible to each other, it is not possible to separate. Okay. So based upon this concept and the reduced phase two, we are going to explain this lead silver nitrate system. So here already we saw the pure nitrate gas phase. So we are going to apply this formula, lead is equal to C minus B plus 1. So next we go to see the phase diagram of lead silver system. So here it is also containing the lines, curves, and its joining of points and its corresponding temperature and pressure. So this is the diagram. So here indicating the 100% silver and 100% lead. Okay. So here we are taking only the silver. So here you see the x-axis and y-axis. In y-axis we are having the temperature, x-axis we are having the composition. So in this side we are having 100% of silver. When the temperature is increased, what happens means the solid silver is starting to melt completely. It's melting means at 961 degree centigrade. Okay. So after that, the composition is increased. What is the meaning means we are adding the lead. Okay. So when we are adding the lead to the melted silver, its temperature is started to decrease by the heat absorption by the lead. So that when the temperature is increased, sorry, decreased, automatically the melting point of the silver is decreased. That is the meaning. So that the silver is started to crystallize out. Okay. So in this curve, we are having the lead, and so here it is given. That is, we are having the solid states and liquid lead and silver. Why the lead is in liquid state means because of gaining the temperature. From here it is starting to melt. Okay. So it is starting to decrease. Okay. So now we go to this area. So here we are having 100% lead. Okay. So when the temperature is increased, the lead is starting to melt. So at 327 degrees centigrade, it is melted and it is decreased. That is continuous addition of silver. The temperature is starting to decrease. So what happens means the lead is start to crystallize out. Okay. So the equilibrium is obtained in any point on the curves. Okay. So the curves are met at a point. This point C. It is called critical point. At this critical point, we are having lead, silver in the solid state and its melting state. Okay. Okay. So this is expanded. That is, AC is known as the freezing point curve of silver. Why it is called freezing point means the after the melting point, due to the addition of the lead, its melting is decreased and it is crystallized off. So at this stage, that is an equilibrium occurring between the solid silver and its melt. So at the curve or at the state, when you are applying the reduced phase curve, we are having the univariate, that is degree of freedom is 1. Similarly, in the BC, that is the freezing point curve of lead, the similar thing what we have explained in the previous slide. So that is an equilibrium occurring between solid lead and its melt. You are applying the reduced phase curve, you are having the univariate. So the point C is the eutectic point. Already I have told, that is the two curves are joined at a point. So it is only noted at the graphical representation. We are not able to see anything practically. So at the point, you are having the one hour. That is the joint at the which temperature it is joined is 390 degrees centigrade. How we are known the temperature is from the graphical representation only. So at 393 degrees centigrade, why it is called eutectic point means at that point we are having the solid lead, solid silver and its melt. So this combination is called as the eutectic mixture. Okay, that point is called eutectic point. The temperature is called eutectic temperature. Okay, so in this eutectic point, when we are applying the reduced phase rule, we are getting zero, that is non-variant. Okay, so already I explained this thing. The C is called eutectic point, the temperature is called eutectic temperature. So at this eutectic temperature or at the eutectic point, how this lead and silver is present and what is the composition? silver is present. Okay, so here it is explained, that is the curves and the areas. So here the area above the line, that is ACP, one is single phase, that is all caught in the liquid phase, because above the melting point of both silver and lead, one is the liquid phase is present. And this thing, when you are applying the phase two, we are getting a bivariate, that is both the temperature and composition is involved. Okay, the next one. Okay, so it is approximately a partition process. This here, this lead and silver combination is called as argentiferous lead. Okay, so in argentiferous lead, the silver content is very, very less, that is 0.1% only it is present. But we want to increase the composition of the silver. What we are doing is, when the temperature is increased, we are slowly decrease the temperature. So the crystallized lead is out. Okay. So due to the percentage of lead is decreased, when it is calculated towards the percentage calculation as 100%, automatically the silver percentage is increased. Okay. It is an approximate method, not it is a confirmed method. Okay. That's the thing. Next one. Okay. So now we are going to the next area, which is alloys. Why this phase rule and alloys are combined means, from the phase diagram only, it is possible to calculate what is the correct composition of the alloy making. Okay, so in alloys, first we are going to define it. So the best example of alloy is the gold. That is, gold is not pure gold what we are getting. It is a combination of gold and copper. Okay, so why this alloy is important? What is alloy? That is, we are going to see in this chart. So alloy is a solid solution. What does this mean? Solid solution means the metals are converted into liquid state and it is mixed, then we are getting a solid. And this combination is two or more elements and one should be metal. For example, the gold and copper. Okay. And if the metal is coming with a mercury mix, it is